Hey there. Today I'm doing something a little more conventional. I'm going to be going through some classic triggers that I have around my art studio. Brushes and so forth. So I hope you enjoy. Let's sit back, relax, check out this brush. Especially nice right on the screen. I use this brush mostly for covering large areas with acrylic, but for even larger areas, sound really nice in actual use too, but that's a little more elaborate setup. Maybe I'll try that someday. Let's see what else I've got here. Same brand of brush. These bristles are a little springier, so they should have some interesting sounds. Thank you. the studio, you use a toothbrush. It's not the same one I used to brush my teeth, don't worry. It's a little softer. Stencil brush. This is very stiff hog hair. It's meant for dabbling paint over a stencil. Let's have a look at that. As you can see, I'm wearing headphones. I think I'm in danger of putting myself to sleep. I like the idea of being able to hear the same thing you're gonna hear. Make sure it all sounds just right. Store, this might look familiar. I worked at an art supply store, and when we brought these in, I kind of blushed. But they're not what they look like. They're meant for splattering paint. Be a little too abrasive for some people. Please let me know what you liked, so I know what to put into future videos. I have a whole giant studio full of art supplies to play with, so hopefully we find some cool stuff. Oh, here's a neat one. This is a tool meant for spreading paint. It's got these fingers that kind of spread the paint in a striped pattern. It's really neat, really fun to play with. off the brushes with my big glaze brush. Probably not gonna, not a lot of sound this way. I use it mostly for oil, so the feel of it is really nice. Unfortunately, I can't share textures with you guys. I wish I could. Has a nice wooden handle. So, as you can tell, not all of my videos are creepy ones. I love making the creepy ones, though. It's nice being unsettled and calmed at the same time. But that's not for everyone, and I have all kinds of other things to show you. So, I'm hoping to get some feedback. I'm going to be making a lot of videos this month. I set myself a goal to make 30 videos, just for fun. Hope you guys like them. So please make requests, leave comments, tell me what you liked and didn't like. This guy here is kind of an unexpected one for me. Sandpaper. If you've ever gotten into drawing or drafting, you'll recognize this. Basically, it's a whole bunch of strips of sandpaper, and you can peel them off as they wear out, and you use them for sanding down the tips of pencils instead of sharpening them to get just the kind of point that you're looking for. Peel apart the layers. So this is a classic. My favorite pair of scissors just does not make quite the right sound. I don't use this pair very often because they just don't cut as well, I find. But back at the barber, just like instantly. ASMR video that I ever saw had some nice scissor sounds in it, and it's really one of my favorites. Okay, I'm not sure how well the cells will come across from this guy, so I'm just gonna give it a shot. My tape ball. I go through a lot of tape, and I thought, why waste it? I'm going to turn this into some kind of sculpture, I think. The reason I go through a lot of tape is because I go through a lot of stencils. After they've been cut out, because they make great sounds. That's just fun. And they crinkle like nothing else. Sensory treats around the studio, and I get to use them and play with all of them, and when it's all done, the only thing left is the visual, which is kind of weird, but yeah, I get to experience all the other parts of the process and have all these wonderful textures and sounds. So this is the stencil film before stencil is cut out of it. It comes in rolls, big rolls that I cut down. And yeah, this stuff is wonderful. I found that when it's it's on a roll. I can do this. Makes me think of playing cards. To play with in the studio. Well, before I get to the last bit, I know everyone loves these. Yeah, those are great. Trying not to spray it at the computer or anything. That sugar was actually from getting the cold wet water on me. But the sound was really great too. Alright, so I'm gonna finish off with one of my favorite parts. One of my favorite things to work with in the studio is paper. Been cutting paper strips and weaving it. So I have all these different kinds of paper. And the sounds they make together are so great. There and leave some more stuff around the studio for next time. I really hope you enjoyed that as much as I did. And yeah, please leave some feedback. Let me know what to do next.